Charles is very nicely dissected, perfectly dissected. This is actually the optic nerve hanging off here. This would be the right hemisphere, and this would be the left hemisphere. So when you put it together, it looks like this. And the covering is what you think?
Dura
mater, yes. The dura mater is the covering. So when you're dissecting, and you would want to clip off the sides here where the tentorium cerebelli is attached, right here. And here, this has been detached. So you're gonna basically detach it from the cerebellum, right? In here, and then we put it together and we go through the structures. So the first part, the first one is the cerebrum. So the cerebrum is this portion right here, this whole area right here. This is the right hemisphere of the cerebrum, and this is the left hemisphere of the cerebrum. Okay? So that's the cerebrum. The cerebellum, which is the little brain, is very nicely shown here. Okay, that's going to be in the back. So that's the cerebellum. Above the cerebellum, below the occipital lobes, is the tentorium cerebelli, which you're going to have to cut, like I said, on the sides in order to release it and push it to the side. Okay, number three is the spinal cord, which is going to be right over here. That's the spinal cord, that's where it starts, basically. The frontal lobe is located in the front. It's convenient enough, right? So that's the frontal lobe, right in here. The parietal lobe is behind it. And in humans, there's a central sulcus that basically divides the frontal lobe from the parietal lobe. So parietal lobe is usually sensory, and frontal lobe has motor component, as well as the frontal prefrontal cortex, which in humans allows us to think and make decisions and so forth. The temporal lobe is quite prominent in sheep, and it's located right here is the temporal lobe. So it's underneath or inferior to the parietal lobe. So this is the frontal, this is the parietal, this is the temporal lobe. Occipital lobe is going to be in the back, right? It's going to be in the posterior aspect of the cerebrum. The left hemisphere and the right hemisphere we already talked about, right? So this would be the left hemisphere, this would be the right hemisphere. And then the fissure in between, where the falx cerebri was located, that has been separated now nicely. So the falx cerebri would be sitting right in the middle, right there, in the medial longitudinal fissure, which is right in between the two hemispheres. So number 10 is the right hemisphere. 11 is the brainstem, which is going to run from the midbrain to the pons to the medulla. And then this right here is the cutoff for the spinal cord right here. This is the spinal cord, medulla, pons, and midbrain. So that's 12 and 13 also. The optic tract, remember, not the optic nerve. The optic nerve is right here. And this specimen is very nicely illustrated right here, the optic nerve. This is the optic nerve also in the medial longitudinal cut, mid-sagittal cut. That's the optic nerve. And where it crosses, right here, is the optic chiasm. And then behind or posterior to the optic chiasm is the optic tract, which means nerve in the central nervous system. So optic tract, optic nerve. Optic nerve, optic tract. Okay. Optic chiasm is right here. So number 15 is where the fibers cross. And when you did that reflex lab, where you shine light in one eye and you saw the pupils constrict in the other eye, it has to do with the optic chiasm, where some of the fibers are going to cross over. Okay, the olfactory bulb. The olfactory bulb is going to be right underneath here. So this structure right here is the olfactory bulb, right in here, olfactory bulb, which is going to give rise to the olfactory tract, which is back here. Okay. On this side. Let's see part of it on this side, the olfactory bulb and the olfactory tract right here. Okay. Midbrain and sulci and gyri. So the midbrain is located right here, and it houses the corpora quadrigemina that I told you about. So these are the superior and inferior colliculi, and this is the midbrain right here. Below that is the pons, and below that is the medulla. The sulci are not so obvious in the sheep brain, but they're basically depressions in the brain. Not like physical mental depression, but basically grooves. And then the gyri are the folds. So this is a gyrus, it's a gyrus, it's a gyrus. And then these dark parts where the blood vessels are located are the sulci covered with pia mater. Okay? So, do you guys have any questions on this portion right here that we talked about?